Hello, hello, sweet peas. How are you doing? Scary times, this one, with this pandemic. Anyway, today I'm going to talk about what to do in these confusing and stressful times, which are affecting all of us. But these events affect us, all of us, in different ways. The disruption to daily life are already being felt by many of us, my family and friends included. And as you can hear from my accent, I am half Italian, and all of my family and friends in Italy are in lockdown. So it's very difficult to keep sanity when you're stuck at home, either by yourself or with people that you never expected to be locked down 24/7. Like, for example, even if you are living with your loved one, your partner, it was nice before when both of you had your own life and times and hobbies and friends. You had a life, and then you decided to live together and you kept having your life and have the partner. Now is you and the partner, you and the partner, or you and the kids, you and the kids, or you and your family. Now, family are, we love them, no? Well, unless we have some difficult family members, but who fall out, but usually we do love our family. But living in the same house under the same roof 24/7 is challenging. It's challenging. It's challenging. And it's because when we pick our friends and partners, we pick people that are similar to us. When we are in a family, we are all different. And that's okay because we are all unique. We're not supposed to be like our parents because we are different people. We are not them. We came to the world through them, not from them. So we have all different personalities and we are all independent. And when you put people with different personalities stuck in the same place, it's difficult. However, I know this lockdown or stay at home or quarantine, whatever you want to call it, it's stressful, but it's necessary. And if you are healthy, it's necessary to the people who have pre-existing conditions or people 60 above. It's been confirmed that those are the people that will risk the most. However, there are plenty of stories, very sad stories, that even healthy young people can't make it. So it's very important that till there is no vaccine, we protect us and the others, and we reduce the time outside as much as we can. Chinese have combat this virus quite successfully. They are resuming to life now. They are slowly coming back to work. You can go back outside because they are monitoring things very well. When they find somebody who has the virus, they put all the contacts of this person and the person in quarantine. So this is how they are reducing the spreading of the virus. Now, plenty of companies are working towards a vaccine, but apparently they won't be able to produce one for the next 12 or 18 months. So it's a long shot, and we need to keep ourselves and our beloved ones safe. And if you consider my grandparents, your grandparents, or maybe your grand-grandparents have been through wars. Some of them have been in concentration camps. So they've been through worst. Now, let's give them a break and let's protect them and to make sure that they live the life till they're supposed to live and not lose them before time. And also, this comparison, I know it's grim, but listen to me. The fact is, if you are stuck at home, it's stressful and it's scary or boring, but think about it, it's better to be stuck at home. Our grandparents. So, or in a concentration camp, so they've been through worse. So, comparing our lives to them is just stay at home to watch Netflix and play video games and read books. I would suggest if you're staying home, try also to improve some skills. Did you want to learn a language? Now is a good time because you have plenty of time. Did you want to learn a skill, embroidery or knitting or, I don't know, painting, whatever it is, now is the time. Do you love animals? Call your local shelters and tell them that if they need, that if they have overflowing of animals, you're there, you have time to take care to foster some. I have done that one yesterday, and actually the person at the shelter was very glad, and she said that a lot of people are actually stepping up because now we have the time. So make the most of it and try to make it a blessing in disguise to maybe grow new skills, even for your work. There are plenty of courses online that most of them are very good, and some of them are free. Like, for example, there is FutureLearn or Coursera that are two platforms that collect a lot of university worldwide, and they do a lot of them. I think most of their courses are free and they are university level. And I'm talking about Wharton Business School, Harvard, Oxford University, Singapore University, UCLA, Sydney University. So global renowned universities are doing free courses on these platforms, or you pay a fee if you want a certificate. So there is no excuse not to expand your knowledge in wherever you want. Also, make sure that you call and reach out to your friends and family members. Connect. It's not a good idea to go and visit them, especially grannies or people with pre-existing condition, because you might not know, but you might have the virus. But call them and ask your neighbors if they need help, if they need you to go and pick them up their prescriptions or grocery. I don't know. Try to be more community oriented as much as you can. Something beautiful that is happening in Italy is that people are getting back to the sense of community, which we lost. And we are tribal. We are tribal beings. So we thrive in communities. And society and iPhones or smartphones and television and have made us very much individualistic. We all are worked up in our own world, but we don't take much care of what's happening around us. And instead, nowadays, people are reading poetry from the rooftop of a building, or playing music, playing an instrument, singing. And it's amazing how people are going back to talk to the neighbor. They're knowing each other. And this never happened because before we didn't need to. But now that's the only interaction they are having from their own balconies with people that don't belong in the family. So something beautiful is happening in these disastrous, dark times. And it's to go back to community. Talk to your neighbors, and not the fake smile that you do to your neighbor, but you didn't even know their name. It's like literally talking to them and asking them how are they, and knowing that they're going through the same thing as you. Because I know these times are scary, but they're scary globally. It's like we have 7 billion people in the world. I bet half of us are freaking out on a daily basis because there is a lot of uncertainty, a lot of I don't know. There is no solution at the moment, apart of people working on a vaccine. Hospitals in Italy, some of them are overflowing with patients. They don't have where to put them. They have put beds in a ambulance garage, and they keep the ambulance outside. They put beds in the corridor. They have so many people. They're literally close to collapse. And if you think about now, this feeling of anxiety and uncertainty are completely normal during times like this. But now imagine you are facing this uncertainty and suffer from some kind of depression or OCD or bipolar or high anxiety. How much more do you struggle? Would you be struggling? And how much more difficult will it be to navigate through this uncertainty? Because while we all are concerned about the future, for those who are struggling with some kind of mental health issue, like anxiety disorders, their worry might be all consuming. And for those with depression, the lack of social engagement and disruption in routines could increase symptoms. I just would like to remind all of you, social distancing does not mean social isolation. Keep contact with your friends and beloved ones and neighbors. Connecting with your friends and loved ones by simply a phone call. Check on them on a regular basis, especially if you know they are staying by themselves or they're struggling at home because the environment is stressful. Check on them. Be there for them. Thank you for listening, Sweet Bees. And keep up the good work, and let's keep up high the spirit in these dark, dark times. Peace.